being here today. I know this is a smaller but mighty crowd, like Dr. Murray said, and I just appreciate you guys coming out. I'm going to talk a little bit about my time at Teleflex, and I'm actually going to stand behind the podium. I apologize. I don't want to drop this, and I have nowhere to put it. Forgive me for that. I actually started in the MEM program in the fall of 2011, so I've been here for a while as a part-time student, and I've been working the full time while doing it, so this presentation is more about my work experience and how it correlates with my MEM experience, and that I will jump into it. And I am actually a biomedical engineer at a local company here down the road, Teleflex. So the presentation, I'm just going to tell you a little bit of my life. My work experience, and then my MEM experience, and I'm going to tell you where that's leading me in my future career goals. So, I have kind of an interesting story. When I was in high school, I actually had some bad things happen to my knees playing high school sports, and I actually tore a bunch of things in my knees. Almost everything you can tear, I tore. So it was quite a disaster. I was a disaster in high school. Anyway, I had a couple reconstructive surgeries on my knees with some of the local orthopedic surgeons here, and it just really made me aware of the medical devices we have in our lives, how much they impact us, how much they impact our families. Without them, you know, there's a lot of procedures that people need, and without these devices, we wouldn't be able to have those procedures. So I'm showing you a picture here of some of the surgery that I had and the instrumentation that was used to fix my knees, which I can say I can actually do a lot of things now with my reconstructed knees. So it was a very good experience. But it definitely made me aware of all the medical devices we have. And that led me to my life experience. I decided I wanted to pursue biomedical engineering. I knew I wanted to do engineering. I thought civil at the time. But I ended up choosing biomedical engineering at NC State, and I see some people in the room that did the same degree as well. So, good to see you. I ended up working in a cell mechanics lab at NC State, where I worked on bone regeneration project. I ended up working at a lab at Virginia Commonwealth University, where I worked on ligament regeneration project. And I also worked on my senior design team, which you can see at the top corner, and we actually designed a instrument for arthroscopic knee repair. So all of these experiences just led me to my career now and led me to the MEM program. So as soon as I finished my undergrad, I started working at Teleflex, and this is just a quick overview slide for you all. We have a couple of different business units, and I'm an engineer in their R&D group. And I actually worked in the surgery department. So it was kind of right down my alley. It's what I wanted to do. And we work with a lot of disposable laparoscopic instruments. And we design a lot of them, and that's what we bring to the market. So a lot of my projects are around bringing certain products to the market and working with the different groups I need to work with and manage so we can get these products reviewed and cleared by the FDA and available globally. So this is just a example. This is actually, if you ever need your gallbladder removed, this is the type of procedure they would do for you. Just for fun. So this is my life every day. I'll give you guys a chance to read this slide. I'm sure you've seen it. You may have seen it before in a class or something. But this is truly what I experience. And coming from the R&D department, working with marketing on different solutions for our customer and just working with operations and supply chain, this is something I experience every day. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the nuances and things I've learned from my life as a project engineer with Teleflex. There are a couple challenges. You don't always get to pick your project team, and this is also true in school. Sometimes we're assigned project teams, so it really relates to life. We have to be willing to work with people, and I've truly learned, like in Professor Ryan's class, that trust is the most important value we can promote within our team. It's so important for everyone to be on the same page, and you have to know what motivates your team members to so you can launch your projects on time, because ultimately we're all judged by deadlines. So if you, the more you know about your team members, the more successful it's gonna, your project's going to be, because you're going to know how to work and interact with them on a daily basis. And I have also learned that team building activities are never a bad idea. So I know we have a lot of MEM activities outside of school, like I think a picnic's coming up or something. It's those ideas are great and something that you should always get involved in. Challenges in the workforce, there's always going to be a budget involved and you're held accountable to it. In school, we don't have to think about this so much, but I've definitely learned that's a big part of my career, being accountable for a budget and creating positive financial impact for the company. I know a lot of us as engineers, especially since we might be in R&D roles, sometimes we may not necessarily see the impact we create for a company until we actually launch our project and start generating revenue. But it's so important to realize that you have value there and you're bringing value to the company every day by trying to get something to market, although the company may not see the value in that right away until they start getting the sales force to sell your product and move forward. So other things that I do on a daily basis are communication with these groups within my company. And I did want to point out one thing. I think MEM, it's awesome how we all come from different places and backgrounds. And it's really helped me to learn how to work with people of different cultures. And especially in work, I work with a lot of manufacturing engineers in Mexico and Germany. And even though I'm not great at Spanish and even 10 times worse at German, it's just been a very eye-opening experience for me to go meet with those engineers and work with them on a daily basis. And I think things I've learned in this program have really helped me with that. Part of my project in launching these laparoscopic instruments to market is to test them to make sure that they're going to be adequate and safe for the people we're putting them in. That's a big thing with the FDA, and that's a big objective I have to meet all the time with my project. So fun part of work is traveling, and I'm sure you all enjoy traveling as well. So I just wanted to point that out. Meeting with surgeons is definitely highlighted my projects. And finally, lessons learned from work and MEM, so people really do make the difference in your life. And as a project manager, leveraging people's strengths is one of the best things you can do. It's also important to never make assumptions about a project or timelines or deliverables and have contingency plans for any project milestones you're trying to meet. And have realistic expectations and expect realistic things from your team members. So in conclusion, just all of these experiences in my life and the Teleflex and my daily projects in MEM, I just know that my future projects with Teleflex are going to be successful because of all these experiences I've had and my future career path, if that's outside of Teleflex as well. I've learned so much from my work experience in this program. It's definitely going to help. Thank you.
Any questions?
So given that you've been working part-time and studying in the MEM program, what has been one takeaway from your work that you brought to the MEM, and what has been one takeaway from the MEM that you brought back to work?
Oh, that's a good one. So one takeaway that I brought from work to MEM, when we took Dr. Skinner's class, the finance class, capital budgeting was something that I had never been really exposed to until that class, but I had been exposed to it at work. So I was definitely able to understand those concepts easier in Dr. Skinner's class because of things I had learned at work and repercussions of bad capital budgeting versus good capital budgeting. So that was very interesting for me. And then things that I brought from MEM to work. Definitely, I love working in MEM teams, and it's different from work. It's actually a lot more fun. we can just, you know, meet, kind of joke around, but we still want to get our deliverables done for class. So it's made me understand the importance at work of just really getting to know people beyond just work time, and getting to know them outside of work and how important that is, so they want to do deliverables for you for your project to help you meet your timelines.
What's been your most exciting project?
My most exciting one of the ones I really enjoyed was where we didn't have a project. We didn't know what our project was going to be. So we were able to travel across the country and meet with different surgeons and just figure out what their hurdles were in procedures and what obstacles they couldn't overcome. It really translated well to the marketing class, where we always have fun getting to know your customer, what are their pain points. It was a perfect translation, and I loved traveling, so I loved going and talking to all those different surgeons and figuring out what their pain points were, so we could translate back to a product design.
Did you ultimately change a product design or develop a new product person?
Yeah, there was a new product design as a result of that.
Would you say was the hardest part about traveling, and how did you adjust to it?
Cool. When we fly to Europe, going there, it's a little difficult sleep-wise. I would say, other than jet lag and answers like that, I think that cultures are very different, and the way engineers are in different cultures is also different. So it's been eye-opening for me, but at the core of everything is what I alluded to earlier, just trust. And when you're working with people and you build a relationship and you trust them, no matter if you're a continent apart, it's so much easier to work with them. And it's also great to meet people face to face and talk to on the phone every